forward. Yeah, good, good. There you go. There you go. Yeah, and you can't go that way when you're ready. Yeah, good. Good. And then just a slight shoulder four here. Slight shoulder four. And make sure you have a little bit of flexion left. Yeah, don't let him grab the inside rein there. Bend him in the corner and left leg. Bump him away from your left leg here. Yeah. And then quarter line, or a little bit past the quarter line, flexion left. Yeah, there you go. Good. And then just leg yield him to the wall and think about making him grow in that. Yeah. That he gets taller when you do the leg yield. Not going down into your hands so much. Slight shoulder four. Not too much curve because it pulls him down. One more time, quarter line, do that again. Flexion left. He's a little stiff on the left, is he?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So keep that little bit of flexion. Yeah. Yeah. Just play with that left rein a little bit to keep him loose on that rein. Good. There you go. Good. And then inside leg to bump him up and under you. Flexion left. Don't let him lean in. Yeah. Good. Good. There's better. Good. Yeah. Good. Better. Yes. Yes. There you go. That's better. That's better. Keep that. Yeah. Don't let him grab that left rein. Good, good. Inside leg, come. Good. That's all right. Doesn't matter. And another exercise that I really, really, really like is leg yield half press in the canter, but not steep. Again, it's still part of your warm up. Just make them really rideable. So you start with a little bit past the quarter line. You leg yield to the wall, and then you half press back a few steps. Not very far, just a few steps. Just about rideability. And then a little bit of half press. And then back to the wall. It's all about getting the inside hind leg to come under and carry. And responsiveness to your legs. Do that again with more bend in the half pass. And once they're more warmed up, you can make it, you know, a little more sideways, especially in the half pass. But in the beginning, just nice and easy back and forth, but still with real bend to the, in the half pass. Jump him sideways a little bit and then jump him back and up and under with the shoulder leading in both and sit a little more in your, call it back pocket. Good. And you can do the same the other direction if you want. But that's, I'm just going to try to show you some of the exercises that I use for really, I think, making them more rideable and good for students too. It shows right away when things are not working so well if they can't do those things. And again, when you're back in trot, if you can get a little more power, you may want to give them a walk break pretty soon. In the middle, but just imagine a 10 meter square, okay, about that size, but not on the wall for starters, just sort of in the middle somewhere, and just show me, you know, a quarter turn in each corner. If it's 12 meter, whatever, it's no big deal, but no need to make it huge. Just, it's just all about getting in and getting out. Yeah, okay. And a little more collection coming into it. So it's small, but only a quarter turn. Yeah, good, that was better. Make sure you start from a straight line. And collection and bend. Bend, yeah. Finish with the shoulder. Keep the bend and make sure you finish on a straight line. Good, do one more. Yeah, good, good, better.
Yeah.
Do one more left and then go ahead and do right the right one. Make sure he doesn't go sideways before you do it. Shoulder four, yes, but not hunches out, because then it's cheating. You're not starting from a straight line. Okay, now stay there and then do the next one to the right, but make it a half a one. And you're going to stay between those two pillars there, or flower pots, whatever they are. Okay, so now get on the line between those two letters and then start and finish there like you would in a test. Bend right, bend right, bend right, bend right. And now help him get back to where, but keep him connected. Don't let him drop the contact. You feel that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. He's got to stay into the contact. Think a little more half pass there, that he really stays. Yeah, bending. And control the hunter's mare. He's falling out now. Shows you out, you're way off the line. You see that? You want to try to get back to that line. Start and finish on the line. Bend, really wrap him around your inside leg. There he kind of just sticks his butt out a little bit, right? Yeah. I guess you don't need him in the Grand Prix, but still.
Harder than I thought it would be. Usually we're quite good.
Watch, yeah, watch his hunches. Yeah, on that first step, that was better. Good, good, that was better. It's on the first step he wanted to swing out there. That was much better though. So he's got to accept that bend. Yeah, got to accept the bend. Yeah, okay. Yeah. And sometimes it's good to do them on the rail too, just to check yourself the size, because sometimes they're much bigger than you think they are when you do them in the rail. Bend left. Wrap him around. Try to feel what's happening. Yeah, good. Keep riding into your hand. Yeah, keep riding. Yeah, that was much better. Much better. Okay, good. Good. So where would you like to move on from there? Trot or canter work?
Canter.
Okay. So pick up the canter again and then do a few more of the, we didn't do the half pass leg yield this way, did we?
No, we didn't do that to the right.
Oh, to the right. Okay. That's what we did. Okay. So just do a few of those, and now that he's more warmed up, do a little bit more sideways in the half pass, and really bend him, yeah, inside leg, yeah, more on the snaffle, jump him up and under, so he grows in the connection there, bend right, and then half pass right when you're ready, and sit, and then jump him sideways, yeah, good, and then back to the wall, keep your left leg back, keep the flexion right, and jump him over, yeah, good, good. Good, good. Now go ahead down the long side, go ahead and do some mediums back and forth. Just go and come back and think about him getting bigger in front when you do that, or taller, that he comes uphill, over the back, and then compress, and then go again from the back end. Come on. Good. And then, yeah, okay, good. And now bring him back, and then come down the center line and just do one half pass to the right, to E. He's really wrapped around your leg, and jump him sideways and uphill. Yeah, good, good, good. Yeah, there you go, good. And then take your time, and then just one big change right between the leg. And then down center line, and do the left one to E. Really exaggerate the bend, and he's really wrapped around your inside leg. That's fine, that's fine. Yeah, good, good. Keep a little bit of flexion left. Stay straight. Yeah, good. 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 Okay. Growing in front. Yeah, you need to jump him underneath you from your seat. And then the half pass left. Bend left. Yeah, keep the jump. Yeah. And now jump him uphill in that. Okay. Downhill there. Sink shoulder in first, even if it means you don't make it to where you want to go, that's okay. Uphill, uphill, uphill. Yes, yes, better.
Yep.
Better. That was better. And then one big flying change. Okay, and then down the long side, do some changes. Any count, but just focus on quality, even if it's whatever, every five or whatever. I don't care, as long as they're straight and forward and through. No count. We'll get to the count. That was late. She's dead straight. Yeah, that was a good one. And yeah, really good. Good. That was good. Really good. Good. Yeah, they were good. Just the first one was late. Good. Keep pushing him through. Yeah. And you can stay just a foot off the rail so he doesn't get feel cramped just a little bit. Yeah, good. Good. Push him through. Good. Yeah, good. Good. Very good. Don't let him drift that far off the rail. So he still stays on the line, but just about a foot away from the wall. And then do some more. You get down to threes and twos and ones, if it feels good. Make sure he's straight. That was a good one. Good. Keep riding him through and over the back. Good. Left leg and rein. Good. Right rein and leg. Okay. That was a little short. That was good. 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 Yeah, very good. How do this feel?
Good.
Yeah. Good. And then try some ones, or do them depending on how you feel. If you want to just do some, that's fine. It feels good. Yeah, good. Keep the jump underneath you. Don't let him go downhill. Jump him uphill. Yeah, good, good, good. But still over the back. Good, good. Good. That looks good. Yeah. Keep him up there. Good. Yeah. Good. Up. Good. 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 Those are nice. Those are nice and expressive. Good. Give them a break. Yeah, good. Got it. Good. Just school him like you normally school him. Yeah, good. Make sure you keep that inside flexion. Good. Then you really make sure that inside rein. Just be careful the hunches don't come in too much, but not bad at all. Just a little bit straighter underneath you with the inside hind leg. So inside hind leg and not start with the hunches. Okay. Yeah? The hunches are still in a little bit too much, ideally. Okay?
Okay.
So try to get the collection by him stepping more straight under you. Even on the straight line there, if you want to just pan on the spot, that inside hind leg has to come straight under you. Don't let it come in. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. And then forward before you lose it. Yeah, good. That's obviously going to be harder, but flexion left. Yeah, good. Good. Better. Keep that activity behind. Good. An exercise I like to do with more schooled horses like him, you know, that's doing Grand Prix level, I actually will have you do like 3 steps of turning, 2 steps of like shoulder in, and then 3 more steps of turning. So it's a working pirouette, but it's really broken down. So you have total control of the steps, okay? And it keeps the inside hind leg stepping forward. So try that. It doesn't have to be. So you do 3 steps of turns or thereabout, and now you make, yeah, and then just two steps of shoulder in, and then 3 more steps. Not so easy. You have to keep him in pirouette canter. Yeah, and then 3 more steps of turning. I know, there's nothing easy about it, but if you can master that, then the pirouettes are easy because it makes them really rideable. Yeah, and bend, keep the bend. Yeah, and the shoulder in just gets him stepping forward and under you for a few steps, right?
Yeah, I like that.
But it's good discipline to do that with the more trained horses. And obviously with a less trained horse, you can still do it, but you make it like 5 and 5 instead of,
yeah,
with a Grand Prix horse, I like to make it like 3 and 2. Just so you're constantly controlling inside hind leg and not just letting them take over halfway through. And for schooling purposes also, for the, when you're actually going to ride the test, instead of doing the full pirouettes on the center line, I do half pirouettes on the center line. And then as they become more and more rideable, you can put them just like 2 meters apart, the 2 halves. But in the beginning, you probably need a little more time until, you know, it all depends on how rideable they are. But that way, they're always waiting for you, and they never take over halfway through.
Mm-hmm.
In schooling. So after you walk in, go ahead and try them. Try doing that, okay, on the center line. Try doing 2 halves. I'm gonna come in as I can. See better the size of them. So just try, and you can put as much space between them as you want. Go past X before you do the first one, so you have plenty of time. If you're going to do the second half, the same one. It's about being able to really control it all the way.
Obviously, the connection wants to like a hard thing.
Okay.
A lot of walking that I can practice, of course, in the test is when it really is. pushing almost like building off the right leg slightly before you start turning right. Yeah, so you just already lean into the right. Yeah, keep him into your hand. Back. Not giving you the inside to bend, right? You've got to really wrap around the inside leg. So as you put him on the spot, he's got to give you the inside strain so you can turn him. Kind of locked against you a little bit on the first step.
To see what happens. I'm very open-minded. I always experiment to see what works best. You know, every horse is so different. So I just kind of play around with it so I see what works. But I definitely find with horses that don't have a lot of natural cadence that it's good to play with the passage first, actually. And when the horses that are trained, obviously. For a lot of passage. Really come, come, come. His hind legs are not doing much, okay? Come, yeah, come on. You tap him with the whip, see if you can get the hind legs doing something. Come. And then as soon as he does, then the reward is to trot on, okay?
Okay.
Just, you ask for a lot, and as soon as he gives that to you, then you can trot as a reward. But the next time you, ask for a lot again. Don't let it just be halfway the size. Yeah, yeah, come on. Yeah, that's right. You're gonna have to motivate the hind legs. Try lowering the neck just a little bit. Just experiment. Because the front legs are good, but the hind legs are not. Yeah, yeah, better. Yeah, okay, and then try it. That's fine. But that worked better for his overall balance, okay? Sometimes you have to just shift the balance just a little bit. Try that again. exercise again. Come. Yeah, okay, okay, good. That was a good motivator there. And then lower his neck just a hair. You got it. Good, better. Yeah, good. Do a couple more times. He's pretty fit, right? Yeah, good. Try a couple more times. Lower his neck. When you feel like the hind legs are not doing anything, lower his neck and then keep asking. Come. Yeah. And touch him on the croup instead.
Okay.
So that it's in the middle of the croup instead of one hind leg kind of gets snatchy. Try that again. Back to beside again and touch him on the croup. Let me just see what he does. Yeah, so he stays. Yeah. Come. Yeah. A little uneven, but he's coming off the ground better now. There, better, and trot. Good. Now, just for experiment, just go straight ahead now, and now try to just add a little passage to your trot. Let's see what happens. Pretend like you're going to passage, and then when he does, then you just go a little less. Yeah, and now just let that a little more forward. So just. Yeah, and then when he gets flat, then back to a little bit of passage. Just a little, yeah. So you have to man-make his trot, okay? And if you can, once a horse learns passage, you can totally make the trot. But you have to really find that line where it's not too passage-y, but teach him that he can do just a little bit of passage in the trot, yeah? Yeah, I mean, obviously that takes time, but you can do it, yeah? Yeah. And as soon as he gives you a little, let it out a little, but don't let it out. Yeah, there. You feel that? Yeah. It's going to take time, but it's totally doable. My first Grand Prix horse had absolutely no trot. He had no gates at all. They were clear, but they were so small. Tapped him on the croup there, then he got a little irregular sometimes, but I think it's workable. And in his case, the piaf will not help your trot, but the passage will. Yeah. And now let it, it's okay. And now let it out just a little. And as soon as he starts running, then bring him back up again until he stops running. Yeah, good. And then let it out a little, but not all the way. This is a process, you know, of patience and diligence, but it can definitely be done and it's worth it. Yeah. And then half halt him back, just one step. Yeah, good. And then let him out a little more forward. Try to keep it, but push him through it a little bit. Yes, better. That's better. Yeah, and then a little forward, from that, yes, better. And keep working on the hind legs the entire time, if they don't get lazy. Yeah, good, come. So even in the trot, tap him with the whip here and there. Good, better.
Yeah.
You feel it?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, good. But just don't forget about the hind legs all the time. That they keep pushing on. Yeah. Now do a little few steps of passage and then try a medium. Let me see what happens. Few steps of passage, tap with the whip. Yeah. Straight and then let him out. Let me just see what happens. Yes. Good. The first couple of steps, it was good. Good. And then back to passage, a few steps, tap. Yeah. And trot on. And then as soon as he runs, half halt. Yes. Good. Step with the whip. Yeah. Press with your left leg a little more. Yeah. Yes. So he gets even. Yeah. It's okay. Doesn't matter at all. Keep working on the hind legs. Yeah. And in the passage also, keep your lower leg back just a little bit. Actually, probably more, because the hind legs, you've got to get a hold of the hind legs. Try posting one. Let me see what he does. Try posting and now do passage posting. Yeah, come on, lower his neck, lower his neck, lower his neck, because it's all front. There. Let him down. Yeah, straight though. Straight, straight, straight. Otherwise, again, he gets irregular. More. More from behind. Come. Tap on top of the croup if you can. Yes, without the neck coming up. Yeah, better trot there, actually. Try it again. You didn't ask for enough massage there. Okay. Just a few steps.
I think I use a lot of seat, and so I just
yeah, that's
exactly
okay.
What I'm doing.
But sometimes I find, especially when I teach, yeah, when I teach them massage, I post. Good, 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 good. That was more even from behind. I don't know if you could feel that. But sometimes it encourages them to get their back up a little better. Again, just experiment. Most of the time when I'm first teaching them, I do that. But with him, when he drops his back, then it might be a good thing to do. Just don't make sure he's straight. Don't turn his head in. He's got to be straight, otherwise he gets irregular behind. Yeah, yeah. Yes, yes. Hind legs, left leg especially. So he steps more through the right hind. Okay, then go back to sitting. You want to give him a break before we do it again? Yeah, good.
And actually, maybe I'll...
Otherwise, he sometimes almost walks behind him, where the front legs are good, but...
Not enough.
No. Oh, nice and quiet out here, huh?
Beautiful.
Yeah, it really is. Is it always like that?
Almost, yeah.
That's great. Yeah, okay. Now consistent. Yes, okay. Yeah, okay. Take your time getting into it. Yeah, okay. And now creep forward. Yeah, okay. Okay. Now keep him in that. Keep him in that. Good. Your legs back just a little bit. Yeah. And keep him a little more under you. A little more under you. Yeah. Come. Yeah. Okay. Just not consistent. It comes and goes. Yeah. Okay. Go across the diagonal once and just stay in the passage. Or trot around once and then come back in passage. Yeah, that's fine. Give him a break, but then back to passage after you trot across. Sit now. Keep your legs back a little bit and really get those hind legs working. Come on, more, more, more. Back to passage. Come, come on. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, come on. Yeah, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter, but you have to put a little more effort into it. Tap him on the croup again. Yes. Yeah. Yes, yes, yes. And then when he runs, half hold him back again. Yeah, good. Yeah, just a little. Okay, down center line. A little more trot. And then when you ask him for passage, he's got a passage, not 10 strides into it. Come on, lower his neck, lower his neck. Yeah, yeah, come. Keep the neck lower a little bit. That helps him behind, okay? Press with your left leg. Press with your left leg. Push his haunches towards me a little bit. Yeah, 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 better. Keep pressing his haunches towards me. Yes, yes. Yes, good, good, and trot on and pet him. Annie, did you feel that?
Yeah.
That was better. You know, there he started to really getting some action behind. Still not 100% even, but it was better when you pushed his butt towards me a little bit. Could you feel that?
Yeah.
Because he wants to keep him the other way a little bit.